Hello students, welcome to the next lecture on the topic nonlinear programming problem. In this lecture I just considered the one particular type of the nonlinear, that's called as the quadratic, and the method we have discussed how to solve the quadratic programming is the my Wolf method. So what is the Wolf method is there? So Wolf method is used for solving the quadratic programming problem. What is the quadratic programming problem? So any function which are representing here as a linear part plus quadratic part, and subjective to some constraints are there, that's a linear constraint. Make sure that it's a linear because of the convexity. And this Q is my symmetric. So it's a symmetric matrix like this. This is my symmetric. The transpose of matrix is itself. And since this is X transpose into X represent define the quadratic term, so it's, that's why this code has a quadratic form. This is a linear because of the convexity. And the most important thing we needed is the Kuh-Tucker conditions are there. What is the meaning of the Kuh-Tucker condition and how to write them? For example, here you can write this into the equality sign. Here S is nothing but my slack variable. So since it is a quadratic side, so I just representing here as a S square instead of my small s. And based on this, you can write the Lagrange function. I think all of you know that how to write the Kuh-Tucker conditions. So this. And what's the necessary condition is you have to derive their derivatives and you will get this one. Okay, so what is this condition is important in the Wolf method is there, that is Lagrange multiply into the slack variable. So what is the steps involved in the Wolf method? There are the six steps involved in that. The first step is the less than sign, must be that, and after that you have to write that equality. Once you write all the equation is the equality, write the KT conditions are there based on the last slide. Once you write here, then this is the derivative form. Now since L is again the quadratic one, so once you derive calculate the derivatives, it means this is my linear function. So once it's a L linear, it's LPP. So how you solve this LPP is with the help of the simplex method. So you can use with the help of the artificial variables, and then simply use the two-phase method of the simplex method and then calculate their optimal solution. So how to solve them, I just explained with the help of the two examples. Okay, so what are those? In the first example I have considered the one constraints, while in the second example I have considered two constraints. So look at that, these methods are there. So first method is, first step is you have to write in terms of the less than sign. So look at that, these non-negativity conditions are not be less than sign, so I just representing here. Now there are the three constraints, so I have to use the equality sign, slack variables are there. So since this is the first constraint, so I have to use lambda 1. Here I use the mu 1 and mu 2. So in the next example also, or while to make the clear distinction, I used lambdas for such type of the constraints, and mu 1, mu 2, mu 3 for such non-negativity conditions are there. Now once you have here, you can drive the Lagrange multiplier, that is this minus lambda times this minus mu times this and minus of mu 2 times this are here. Now you can write their derivatives with respect to x1, you will get this equation. X2 you can easily drive that, lambda 1 is here. Okay, so since it is 0, so the first equation you can write easily as a 4x1 plus 2x2 plus lambda 1 minus of mu 1 is equal to 4. Similarly, you can add the second equation, third equations, and so on. So since it is a linear and these are my slack variables, I just consider here as capital SI as a small SI, and these are my KT conditions sample. So based on this, you can simply drive their LPP are there. So first objective function from here is 4x1 plus 2x2 plus lambda 1 minus of mu 1 is equal to 4. So you can write, and second one is 2x1 plus 4x2 plus 2 lambda 1 minus of mu 2 is equal to 6, and so on. So based on this, you can add the artificial variable in the first one, second, and these are my smallest. Now since this is the LPP, now you can solve it with the help of the simplex method. So how you write them, since there are the variables, write the value of the x1 is 4, 2 and 1. This is 4, 2, and 1. Similarly, you can find the other values. How you find the zj minus cj? What is the value of the a1 is? These are the values corresponding to the objective functions. So the value of the a1 is minus 1. Value of the a2 is again minus 1. S1 is 0. How you find this value is? Multiply this with this. Minus 1 multiply 4. Plus minus 1 multiply 2. Okay. Plus third value is 0 multiply by 2. This is the value of the zj. Now second is minus. What is the cj of the this value corresponding is 0. So the answer will be minus 6. So this value is my minus 6. Similarly, you can find here, this is minus 2, minus 4, 0, minus of 0, and so on. Now after that, you can enter the true value. So the most negative part is this. You can enter through this and calculate the minimum ratio. What is the minimum ratio is 4 by 4, 6 by 2, and 2 by 2. So this and these are same, but my preference always given to the artificial variable. So this is my leaving. Okay. So how you find? So I just tell you the simplest method. Instead of writing R2 minus 4 R1, R3 minus 3 R1, I have to write these all values in a very simple manner. Always remember, the first column is X1. So write simply A2, so that's the second value. So A2, second value 1, rest are 0. S1, S1 is there, there's a third value 1, while others are 0. Okay, so all values are 0. Divided this box element throughout. So 4 divided by 4, 2 divided by 4, 1 divided by 4, minus 1 divided by 4, 0, 1 by 4, 0, 0, 1. Now, how to find this? So all of you know that how to find the values of this row. You can find this either multiply this row by 6 and add them, you will get this line. How you find this? Multiply this line by 2, subtract them, you will get this, and so on. But I just tell you the simplest method is there. For example, I just want to calculate this value. Okay, so how you find that? What is the previous value of this? That is minus 1, plus 1. Okay, so just write this in the determinant. What is that value is here? 4, that is a box element, always be there. What is the value? I just want to calculate. Previous value is 1. I just write here because value 1 lies above of the 4. And make the two values in such a way that it form a box. So look at that. If I just consider as a 0 and other value minus 6. So it look at that. These form a box. So these values are here. Then find the determinant of this. So how you find the determinant is this minus of this. But here, remember, the determinant starts with the box element always. Okay, so that this is my 4 plus 0. So answer will be 4. And the if you write here, so the answer will be 4 divide answer of whatever the answer you get divided with the box element. So you will get here as a 1. Okay, I just calculate the other values are also so that you may able to recognize that. So for example, I just want to calculate this value. So what is the previous value of this is 0. One box element is there. So I just write 4, 0 is here. What is the remaining two values are there? So this value, this value. So what is the remaining two values so that it form a box? 4, 2, 0, minus 1. 4, 2, 0, minus 1. So calculate the determinant, start from the box element. 0 plus 2. So the answer will be 2 divided with the box element. So the answer is 1. Okay, similarly, if you want to calculate this value, what is the previous value is minus 10. One value is 4 must be there. Okay, and the other two values are minus 6 and plus 4. Minus 6 plus 4, and the box element is here. So start with here, calculate the determinant is my minus 40. This is my plus 24. So the answer will be minus 16 divided with the box element. So box element is my 4, so it will be my minus 4. Similarly, you can calculate the other value. So I just quickly calculate this value. What is that? This previous value is here. What is the box? Other two values are this and this. Start with here. This is 0 minus 4 divided with the box element. It is my minus 1. And so Now the next one is you have to enter the most negative. So here you have entered through this. What is the leaving one is? The ratio here is my 2. This is 4 divided by 3. It is 1 divided by 2 divided by 3. So this is my minimum ratio. So this is my box value. So look at that meaning. So this is wrong. This is my box value. Okay, so what's the value of here? So I just calculate to write here as a ZJ minus CJ also. So X1 is 100, A2 is my second column, X2 is my third column. Okay, and divided this line with the box element and calculate again with the, I just say for example here, what is the value of here is, one is box element, second is this, what's the remaining two is 0 and 3. So look at that, minus 3, 1, 0, 3 by 2. So this is my box element. Calculate the determinant, start from here. So this is 3 by 2 plus 0. So divided with the box element is there. So answer is 1. So that answer will be 1. So based on this, you have to calculate this. Look at that, this value is 1. Okay. So again, since all our values are not negative, so you have to enter through here. Okay. And then calculate the ratio, you will get this table. Now since all the values are positive, so it means the optimal solution reached. So what is the answer is, X1 is my 1 by 3, X2 is my 5 by 6, and the value of the Z is my, since Z is my this, so substitute this value here, you will get this optimal answer. So no problem, I just quickly solve with the second example. Here I just consider two constraints. So firstly you have to write the step 1, all the constraint must be less than sign since these are there, but this is not there. Right, equality S1 is 12 here. So here I just considered lambda 1, lambda 2, mu 1, mu 2. So you can write here in the KT conditions, write their necessary condition this, and then you can write there, use the notation this. The first one is 2x1 plus lambda 2 and so on. This one, okay, and this is the KT conditions are there. Write the modified LPP, use the artificial variables here are there. Now in the last example there is no role of these constraints are there, but I just explain you what is the meaning of here. So you can write the values here based on this. Look at that, this is a 2022. So look at that, 2022, and you can find the values here, this one. Now you can enter through lambda 1. Fine. You can enter through here. What is the minimum ratio is? 2 divided by 2 and 1 divided by 3. So this is my leaving one. In the next table, you will get A1, lambda 1, S1, S2. But look at that. This condition means, what is the meaning of this? It means lambda 1 and S1 can't occur together. That is the meaning of this, can't occur together in the basic variables. So what is my basic variable is representing here as a VP. So in the next table, look at that, the value of lambda 1 and S1 appears both together, but this condition, that is a KT condition, means that this can't occur together. Similarly, the meaning of this is mu 1 and X1 can't occur together. So what is the meaning is, if you enter through this, then lambda 1 and S1 both occur together, but this condition violates them. It means you can't enter through this one. Then the next one is you can enter through this. If you enter through lambda 2, again lambda 2 appears on the S2 and S2 appears here. So it means you can't enter through this. What is the next value is X1. So if you enter through X1, X1 is related with a mu 1. And mu 1 is not present, so it means you can enter through this one. So you can enter through this. What is the minimum ratio is this, so you can leave this. So S1 is this is my 1000. Okay, so A2 is my second value, this S1 is my third value. Oh, sorry, this is my third value, S2 is my fourth value. Okay, and the ZJ are always be 0 for here. Divided this line by the 2, so it by this minus 1 by 2, 0, 1 by 2 and 1, and calculate the remaining value same with the help of the box rule. So I just calculate the one value for your sake of simplicity. Say here, what is the previous value is minus 3. So I just start with the box is 2, previous value is minus 3. What is the other two values are there? Minus 2 and plus 2. So calculate that determinant, start from the box element. So minus 6 plus 4, that is minus 2, divided with the box element. So this is my 1. If you feel this method is quite difficult, you can write as usual, multiply with the 2, add them in the above row. Multiply with this line as a 2, subtract from here, multiply with the 2, subtract from this, you can find these remaining values. So this value is my 1, so look at that, this value is my, this is minus 2 divided by 2 is my minus 1. So look at, and in the next one, since this is there, so if you enter from the lambda 1, and since again S1 is present, so you can't enter through this. Lambda 2, if you enter through this, again S2 is present, so it violates that, again you can enter. And since all the values are positive, so but it is not optimal. But look at that, this X2 is not present here. It means this is not the basic, this is a non-basic. So it means you have to enter through this. What is, if you enter through this, what is the minimum ratio? This is 0, you can't calculate. This can't calculate, this is 4 by 3, this is 2 by 1. So this is my minimum value. So you can enter through this and here. So what is the value is here? This. Again you can write this, this simply. A2 is my 0, 1, 0, 0. X2 is my this. S2 is my this. Okay. And divided, since this is my box element, you have entered here. So divided this line by 3. And then you have calculated the remaining values again by the box element. So if I just want to calculate here, what is that? 3, previous value is my minus 1. So starts in the box, other values are 0, minus 2. So this is my minus 3 plus 2. So minus 3 divided by 3 is my minus 1. Okay, similarly for the others, you can calculate them. Okay, so the values are here. Again, since both values are ZJ minus CD are not positive, so it means if you enter through here, that is lambda 1. Now look at that, S1 does not appear, so it means it is possible. Okay, so but lambda 2, you can't enter through the lambda 2 because lambda 2 and S2, but S2 places. So if you enter through this, what is the minimum ratio? Is 1 by 1, 1 by 3. So this is leaving variable. So look at that, this is the leaving variable. So you can repeat them, you will get this value. So since all the values are positive, so this is my optimal solution. So what is my optimal one is, X1 is my 2 by 3, X2 is my 14 by 9, substitute here, you will get this final optimal. So this is the way how to solve this Wolf method. So some questions are practice for you, you can solve it, these are some answers are there. Infeasible means, when you get the infeasible, when you try to solve this optimal solution, but still, here A1, A2 or A3, any one of the AIs are present, you will get their infeasible solution. If you feel any doubt, you can send me an email, you can follow my webpage, you can follow my YouTube channel for the next methods, for the next video lecture. Till then, best of luck.